Welcome back. This is episode 112, and as promised, we are going to start by doing Solus's companion quest. So, I believe he marked a new location on our map somewhere. Lost Temple? No, it's the temple we went to before. Is it over here? I think this is it. No. This is Cassandra's quest. Alright, let's go back then and take a look at the quest log and see what it says. Inner Circle. In the Exalted Plains. Alright, that's where we're going then. That's good, haven't been there in a while. And it looks like Spirit is down here by the Dalish camp. So, we'll say hi to our Dalish friends again. It'll be kind of surprising if they're still there, but I'd be kind of surprised if they weren't. Just choosing kind of random companions at this point. I'm expecting there to be some combat this time, but I'm not sure how much, so we shall see. A codex entry about Stroud. Wonder if we'll see him again if we return to the Fade at some point. I wouldn't rule it out. Alright, find the spirit with Solus in the Exalted Plains. Hello, everyone. Fresh fine. Alright, well, I do still have... I did look up, there actually aren't any hollow mounts, which is kind of unfortunate. You'd think there would be. Seems like an obvious choice, but we do have my snowy heart here, whatever it's called. I kind of do want to ride one of the more, like, elven-oriented ones. There's one you can buy from the merchant, too, called the Pride of Arlathan. But I like the look of this one better. Also, apparently you take no fall damage while you're on mounts, so that's kind of cool. Although,
Thank you for this, Inquisitor. We are not far from where my friend was summoned.
It forced me to dismount there. I don't know if it's because I ran into the cliff or because of Solus's thing. Maybe because of Solus's thing, actually. Oh, a quarry! Didn't we need one of these a long time ago? Probably. We probably walked right by it, too. Oh, well. Oh, what is that? Kind of ritual or something?
My friend.
A demon of pride now. Ah! That sucks. And yeah, because I guess I'm a mage. And that's a different icon though. It's not the usual mage icon. And it's not the arcane knowledge one either, I don't think. I'm not sure what that one means.
The mages turned your friend into a demon.
Yes.
You said it was a spirit of wisdom, not a fighter.
A spirit becomes a demon when denied its original purpose.
So they summoned it for something so opposed to its own nature that it was corrupted. Fighting.
Let us ask them.
A mage! You're not with the bandits? Do you have any lyrium potions? Most of us are exhausted. We've been fighting that demon. You summoned that demon! Except it was a spirit of wisdom at the time.
Interesting.
You made it kill! You twisted it against its purpose! I understand how it might be confusing to someone who has not studied demons, but after you help us, I can...
We are not here to help you!
Solus is smarter than you are. He definitely knows more about demons than that guy does.
We came to help your friend. Any way to do that now that it's a demon?
You cannot befriend a demon? However amicable it might appear, it must...
I guess it's a one-way change.
Shut up! You summoned it to protect you from the bandits!
I... Yes.
You bound it to obedience, then commanded it to kill. That is when it turned. The summoning circle. We break it, we break the binding. No orders to kill, no conflict with its nature, no demon.
What? The binding is the only thing keeping the demon from killing us. Whatever it was before, it is a monster now.
Inquisitor, please.
Interesting. So I guess it's, do we take the risk and hope that releasing the binding circle turns it back, or do we just kill it while it's vulnerable? I'm leaning towards trusting Solus in this one, because hopefully his judgment isn't being clouded by him wanting to help his friend. He doesn't know a lot about spirits and demons, so if he's thinking logically, I would tend to believe him. So, ooh, we can I don't know what that one is still. Is that because you're a certain level as a mage, maybe? Or, we'll save your friend. It's basically yes, yes, no. It seems like these are also just yes. I guess because we're both rift mages. Let's see if that... I really want to know what that icon means, though.
Rifts are gateways to the Fade. I can use that magic to overload the binding more quickly.
Thank you. We must hurry!
I do get the feeling this might not work, though. But we shall see. Alright, deal with the demon. I see red dots around here, though. Does that mean we can kill the... Oh, it is summoning stone. Sweet. Alright, let's put... Yeah, but I said I didn't want to kill the demon by accident. Careful who you target. Oh, it's going away, I think. One more. That's all of them. I'm not unhappy, I'm me again. You helped me, now you must endure. Guide me into death. As you say. Didn't know spirits could actually die. I thought they just kind of like returned to the Fade. Or were like dispersed or something.
I heard what it said. It was right. You did help it.
No. I must endure.
Let me know if I can help.
You already have. All that remains now is them.
Thank you. We would not have risked the summoning, but the roads are too dangerous to travel unprotected.
You have magic, though.
You tortured and killed my friend.
We didn't know it was just the spirit. The book said it could help us.
Yeah, I don't think Solas should commit murder. So we're gonna stop Solas from killing them. Like, I agree with what they did was wrong, but I don't think they should die because of it.
Solas.
Never again. I need some time alone. I will meet you back at Skyhold.
Alright, well. Then there were three. At least there was a little bit of fighting here. Again, it's a short quest, like all the companion quests, but this one's actually pretty interesting. And back to Skyhold we go. How to act for Elden. People want to act for Elden? Is that a thing in Orlais now? Didn't really have time to read it.
Inquisitor.
How are you, Solas?
It hurts. It always does. But I will survive.
Thank you for coming back.
You were a true friend. You did everything you could to help. I could hardly abandon you now.
I wonder if you, if you don't have high affection with him, or if you aren't in a romance or something, if there's a way to drive him away. Because it seems like he's one of the companions that may be important to the plot, with all this, like, talk of elven ruins and the elven spear... Not spear. The elven sphere. And, the Fade. He's an expert in the Fade. He seems like one of the ones that you might actually need to have for some, like, for the exposition of what's about to happen, as far as the main quest goes.
Where did you go?
I found a quiet spot and went to sleep. I visited the place in the Fade where my friend used to be. It's empty. But there are stirrings of energy in the void. Someday something new may grow there.
Yeah, that's what I really want to know. What is that like to spirits?
What happens when a spirit dies?
It isn't the same for mortals. The energy of spirits returns to the Fade. If the idea giving the spirit form is strong, or if the memory has shaped other spirits, it may someday rise again.
Yeah, about to say, I don't know, do spirits reproduce? And if so, like, how? They don't really explain much about, like, the life cycle of spirits. I kind of thought they were just, like, immortal and couldn't truly be born or killed. I want to choose both of these. So let's see if we can do that.
You're saying your friend might come back?
No, not really. A spirit's natural state is peaceful semi-existence. It is rare to be able to reflect reality. Something similar may reform one day, but it might have a different personality. It would likely not remember me. It would not be the friend I knew.
The next time you have to mourn, you don't need to be alone.
It's been so long since I could trust someone.
I know.
I'll work on it. And thank you.
Alright, so that was a cool little quest. But we still have plenty of time in this episode to play, so I think we're probably going to head to the Emerald Graves then. So we do have a few quests there. And that is this one. Alright, so what areas, I guess, is there more of the map around here we haven't explored? I'm not sure. There definitely is an ocularum somewhere. There's a quest here, too. Inquisition agents have lured Carol, the Red Templar responsible for manipulating the Freemen of the Dales. That's right, okay. So let's head to this camp. If he's a Templar, let's bring Cassandra. And I don't know who else would be good. Let's give Solas some time to mourn. We'll take these three. I noticed we're not too far away from getting another level, too, so I don't know what point I will spend at that point, but at the very least, it's some more stats. High Chancellor Roderick, I almost forgot about him. I wanted to read more about his organization, because it does seem where there are men in the Chantry, but they're not priests, of course, but they are involved. Alright, so let's put a little marker. Actually, let's just make that our main quest. Set active. And we'll head out and defeat Carol the Templar. There's the violins again. Yeah, this is probably my favorite zone in the game, I think. Just lush forest everywhere. It does seem like the kind of place where you'd expect elves to live. So it's fitting that I like it because I'm playing an elf character. I don't usually play elven characters, but I'm really glad I did this time. And I guess that's Carol and his crew. Level 19. It seems like things don't really scale above 19 for much of the game. Even though you can go beyond level 19. And that dragon was level 20. Come to think of it, I don't know if I've actually faced any buyer higher than level 20. Hopefully they scale during the main quest. Right, Vivian has a blizzard now too. I'm like, wait a minute, Solas is in here. How is there a blizzard? There's Carol. Get him. Very Red Templary. Cassandra. Oh, what are you doing? I remember the fire mine. Oh, there we go. Good job. Intense Red Lyrian. I guess that's her runes of cleansing. Or whatever her runes of corruption. Whatever the anti Red Templar one is. Alright, so that was I don't remember getting that quest. I guess it was part of a operation or something. I do remember the operation that we sent people on to help our friend, the other Dalish elf. So that'll be fun. I'm looking forward to doing that. And that quest is over here, it looks like. Yep, the Knight's Tomb. The Dalish investigating the tomb of the Emerald Knights report progress, but they ask for Inquisition aid in lieu of support from their keeper. That sounds like it has the potential for some conflict, but I always like learning about history, so we're going to be tomb raiders today. That's right, remember a long time ago when the elves yelled at me for disturbing the graves of other elves? I almost forgot about that. It seems like a whole other game ago, but it was this game back in the Exalted Plains. Okay. Arbor Blessing, which I don't know why I'm gathering. We don't really need it. I guess it's this way. They must be inside.
Maker have mercy. It's Taven's party.
Oh, they're killed.
Most were unarmed. They didn't stand a chance.
What killed them?
There should be Inquisition soldiers here.
Well, I didn't see that coming. That's kind of a shame. Graves, do it this way. Knight's Tomb. Well, as soon as we get out of combat, we will head inside to Dinan Hanin and see what exactly killed them and what happened to our Inquisition forces. Were they traitors? Were they killed as well? Did they not show up in time? The plot thickens. It's a new zone, so this could be interesting. Turn to the tomb. Well, we are here.
These are our men.
So they were killed as well. The Emerald Knights curse the past, the place where lies were born. For beneath their sun our people fall. The lands their lady once bestowed, now stolen in her name. So when these words are read, we shall be gone. Yeah, when the... I'm not sure what exactly happened that sparked it, but eventually the Chantry or an exalted march against the Dales purged it of elves, even though they gave them the Dales for what Shartan did for Andraste. And that's when oh look,
shall we deprive Corypheus of his lackeys?
Let's do it. That's when that rift is not gonna catch anybody. That's when the Canticle of Shartan became one of the dissonant verses. Which is, I guess, the equivalent of, like, I don't know how to pronounce it, Apocrypha? Something like that. Whatever you call the books of the Bible that aren't officially canon. Hey, we got a requisition done. That's something, I guess. Lots of message fragments. These guys must carry on a lot of messages. Wow. I feel like that's like a whole message. We must have like torn up when we killed him or something, because... What is this? Am I looking at the wrong quest? I see a quest marker there, but it's not... Well, that was cool. Was that just... the kill animation, or is that something special? See, there's... Or is that one of my companions? Is it moving?
Them. Maybe yeah. We can figure out what they were after.
It's something on his corpse. An emerald seal. Part of some kind of ceramic Dalish seal.
Corypheus's men had part of a seal. Do they even know what it opens?
I doubt they care, so long as they can claim it.
Well, I think we're about to find out. Oh, we have to find 9 pieces of the seal. I gotcha. Alright, so there's probably going to be a lot of stuff to do here then. Which I'm okay with. It's been a while since we've had like a nice fighting dungeon level. It's kind of pretty too. Very nice elven ruin. I like their chanting. And I like my combo. These guys are only level 15 though. This should be kind of a cakewalk. There's more up there.
Back me up!
I'm shot. It's just a little Bronto. I am still gonna loot people just in case. Although I will try not to do much gathering anymore. After training myself to gather everything I can see for the rest of this game, it's gonna be difficult though. Because I can get like rings like that one that might be potentially useful. Like if I find like an immolate damage ring, if there even is such a thing, I might use it. Although it's quite possible that a ring either has duration or damage and not both. I'm not sure if I've seen a type of ring that has one of each kind yet. But it would be weird if they didn't. Alright, so I guess we just have to kind of explore. So this is sort of like the chateau level then, that mansion we were in. We have to explore until we find something cool. He sees us. Good freeze. Must have been Winter's Grasp, I guess. So it looks like the behemoths carry the seals and a mosaic piece of invasion. It does seem like they're kind of associated with different zones, but not entirely. Are there like lower levels or upper levels? There's purple all around here, but we killed the only behemoth in the immediate vicinity. There's another purple area up here, but we already were up here. Right, there is something down here that we missed. Or up there, I see. More loot. Still, we are only at 2 of 9. If this is 1, it's going to be 3 of 9, but it might not be. It's not. Alright, it looks like came in that way, right? So to go ahead, I say we go up there. See, it says there's still something there, but I think that might just be the guy I actually killed, and there might not still be anything there, even though it's still glowing. Because I very much doubt there are 9 things in this zone. So we press onward. Should be one around here. There's a ladder, which I will actually climb for a change. Can we go up here? I'm guessing no. I think, oh, I think I saw something though. Best I think I'm right, but oh, there is, there's loot there. Aha, you can go up here. Tricky Bioware. It's probably nothing good, but worth a shot. Gold. Could be worse. Interesting carvings. Nothing good here. Is this the gate? Or is this something that maybe Cole could open for us? Yay, so maybe you, well, maybe not. This is just a closet. Heavily locked closet, but there's no good loot here for one. And there's definitely no seal here. Hopefully there's 7 more yet ahead. Oh, do I want to jump down there? Maybe not. Not sure how you get back up. Well, we will head down there, but not right away. Wonder if that's I forgot. Mithril, maybe? I'm not sure what the goddesses and gods look like. Maybe it'll tell me. Oh, these are the Emerald Knights, right. Forget not the past, it is all that remains. For each knight a seed was sown, roots twisting with their brothers and sisters. So the forest remains a reflection of our sorrow.
Do statues help people remember?
Yes, they do, Cole. Yes, they do. Alright, I still love that idea of the trees planted for these brave elven warriors. It makes a lot of sense. Very poetic. I think I just knocked him right out of my fire mine. that from? Weakened. Oh, I'm weakened. Taste of my own medicine, I guess. Didn't see any Red Templars, though. So we're actually fighting Minotauri and Red Templars here, which is somewhat unusual. Usually you fight one or the other in an area, except as part of the main quest. But they are on the same side, after all. There's something over here. Another locked door down there, I guess? Not really sure. But I do see a Red Templar there. That's right. Buff up my fire spell first. Weaken him. There we go. A skeleton, you can still see it. I guess they would still have a skeleton, a corrupted, deformed skeleton, but they were once human. Or possibly elves, but more likely humans. There are not very many elven templars. I don't know if I've ever met any, but there's gotta be at least one somewhere in Thedas. Balefire. Hey, yeah, guys. Did we get him? I think so. So this Balefire is probably going to lead to a Veil rune at some point. Where we can get another rune schematic. Which I guess if it's Fire or Frost, we actually could use. We could craft one of those for our two companions who are using those types of runes. But I'm not going to worry about it too much right now. This place is big. I don't know how you go from like the tiny level design and the repetitive level design of... Oh, something's here. Why is it giving me tutorials again?
There might be something here. Better take a closer look.
As I was saying, I don't know how you go from the tiny level design of Dragon Age 2 to the sprawling, awesome level design of this game. Oh, there's a seal. So not all on the Red Templars then. Some of them are just lying around. We had better be thorough in our search then. See somebody up here. Or above me, maybe. Nope, there he is. Oh, good teleport there. I think we killed him, though. Pick up my torch again. Nothing good from him. I guess we can use the map too to help us navigate a bit. This almost reminds me more of like an Elder Scrolls level than a Dragon Age level. Not necessarily a bad thing though. Dead end, turn around. Probably another dead end. Yep. Sometimes I hate being right. Alright, let's head back up. I hear whispers too. It's kind of creepy. Alright, I don't think we've actually been... Oh, we have been up here. I see where we are. We've been down there. See, I don't want to jump and then find out that... Yes, we have been down there. That'd be weird. Oh, a secret door. Something behind it, maybe? Cassandra, if you would. Wonder if there'll be like a mage thing to animate as well. Oh, oh, there we go. There's the Veil rune. Not but blood and torn flesh, but a mother knows her child. Saran, Falandin, Ansal, and Naste. Huh. Not really sure what that means. Did somebody lose a child? Is it on the skeleton? No. Aha. There's a seal. 5 of 9, we're getting there. Is this the main door? No, this is another door that Cole can open by the looks of it. hear something. Oh, more Veilfire. Frail, faltering in the darkness, though imperfect, her voice a balm. Androlay, Falindin, Anasil, Anaste. So these must be actually be the graves then, or like the gravestones. That probably means like Dreadwolf watch over you or something like that. So there's still a lock icon below me or above me. Maybe above me, because I feel like, well, it's hard to tell if there's more down there or not. Arlathan part 2. You asked what happened to Arlathan? Sadly, we do not know. Even those of us who keep the ancient lore have no record of what truly happened. What we have are accounts of the days before the fall, and a fable of the whims of the gods. That's true, they never really say what happened to the dwarves. The main belief is that the Tevinter Imperium just rose up and conquered them, but knowing how powerful their elves were, I get a feeling there's a lot more to it than that. Is that an exit there? It is. In case you're lost, I guess. This actually reminds me of one of the many dungeons in Guild Wars 2. So that one was more icy, though. Alright, we have to go upstairs, it looks like. Well, let's try to go down and see what happens. Okay, so that is not a level. I was about to say, oh, there's a level down here. But there's not. Sorry about that. Clicked off the screen for a second there. Can read another statue here. Mourn for the past and all that was left there, for we trusted in dreams and perceived immortality. We trusted in promises and in hope. So we dreamed in vain, for we lost these gifts long ago. Alright, I'm getting to the point where I'm kind of worried, because there are four more of these left. Oh, maybe only three now. So I think we've explored most of this place, so I might have missed a couple. Maybe there were some back where those purple things were. Let's see if it goes away when I get this one. It did, okay. So it seems likely then that the markers were not actually incorrect. Let's head back a little bit then. Back at the lower level for now. And see, because at the time I assumed that only the Red Templars had these things, but apparently some of them are just lying around. Probably on a higher level though. See, it says there's one like right around here. But I do not see anything. And then there's these two purple areas back here. Oh, there's somebody. Or beneath me, was there a behemoth we missed? How do we get to him, though? There's a book, Arlathan Part 1. Might be a cool one to read for the elven lore, but I already vaguely remember the story. And that's an easy codex to find online if you want to hear the story of Arlathan. I don't think there will be any Inquisition spoilers, but obviously I can't guarantee that, having not played the end of the game. Can I go down there? It certainly looks like I can, but I guess not. This is how we came in, right? Yeah, there's no purple around here. So, I think we read that one already. Well, I guess not, because they disappear when you read them, but if you want to read that, you're going to have to go back and pause the video, because I thought we already had. Alright, so this is where we came in. Only three left. Where could they be? Maybe I was wrong twice over, and the purple areas are actually not telling us anything useful. Maybe I was right the first time. Whoop! Wrong thrice, it seems. Alright, here we go. That's that one. And there's going to be one more pile of junk down here somewhere. And a bad guy, too. That's what confused me, though, because there is a red dot on the map, or there was. See? There is right now. So he's got to be, like, above us or below us. Can I jump through here? Didn't think so. And that's not a door. Alright, but you can get down there. Oh, I see. Okay. I'm going to follow the map, and it seems to lead in the direction I need to go. So I'm optimistic at this point. I gotcha. And then we go down here, and then through there. It was almost overkill. Where'd he go? Now he's dead. Okay, resupply. Not that we really need to, but I guess might as well. And I will read this one. Sing for the past where rest those who came before. For each night a seed was sown, roots twisting with their brothers and sisters, so the forest grew a reflection of our might. I think the other one had the exact same inscription, though. At least a very similar one. Alright, that's 8 of 9, and the last one, as you can tell, is way in the deepest parts there, so that's where we're going to head next. And then I guess we can open the main part of the tomb and get our reward. It'll probably be like a nice purple item we actually can't use, but I wasn't doing this for rewards, I was doing this for fun. But you never know, it could be something useful. I suppose there's only one way to find out for sure. It does remind me a little of the elven architecture in the first game. Obviously, much better graphics, and, you know, changed in a lot of ways, but the overall architectural style is still somewhat similar. So I like that they at least kept that. It seems like they tried to do the same with the dwarves, too. It did definitely change over the years, but even then it kind of makes sense, because different dwarven areas would have different styles. Why did the door close behind me? That's kind of creepy. Is there somebody else in here? And there is another door to unlock. That's the ladder back there. Okay. So we're on the right level now. We just missed a turn, it looks like. There we are. There's some enemies up ahead too, though. Balefire. There don't seem to be any, like, rune inscriptions here, but there do seem to be, like, other things to read. Alright. There we go. And that's the last of them. Right here, though, I'm thinking these torches are more just to make like a ceremonial entryway. More than anything else.
This is it. Whatever Taven hoped to find, it's here.
Is that it? Looks like it might be dangerous. Explore a bit first. You never know when grabbing an artifact may cause like the entire temple to cave in. I learned that from Indiana Jones. I haven't seen this movie in a long time. Kind of want to now. Anything hidden behind here? Not really. Oh, there is something. Two emerged within an eve, as one they fought, as one fell. Rin, Ilan, Falandin, and Sal, and Aste. I assume these names correspond to the trees that I saw outside. That would only make sense. Then again, they're not... Okay. I guess they're not actually buried under the trees. They're buried here, because this is their tomb, obviously. The trees were just planted in memory of them. A lot of times when you plant a tree, at least in the olden days, they'd plant it, like, on the place where the person died, but... Maybe they did put it on the place where they died. They just moved their corpse first. And probably cremated them. I don't know if the elves cremate or not. You think they would, because of, you know, demons, but... You never know. Alright, what is... do I have to, like, energize a bridge to it? Probably. Or is there a puzzle? All this veil fire, there might be a puzzle. I wouldn't be surprised at all. Can't jump on those, though, so I don't see anything. I mean, this definitely seems like a puzzle-based room. It also could be that there's just an energized thing up there, and this is just a place to fall in case you, you know, don't do it. See anything. What if I light all of these? Does that do something? I hear something. Oh, hey, bad guys. Corpses, which is good, because my staff does more against corpses. Not that it really matters much around here. Makes it go a little faster, I guess. All the loot. Probably not anything good, though. Navarre Medal of Service. Guess these corpses were from Navarre? Not sure that makes a lot of sense, but okay. Alright, let's light the other two and see if that opens up some kind of... Was that because of my torch, or was there actually something there? For a second, it looked like something might be in the process of forming there, as we light the braziers. Oh, there we go. Whoa, that was cool. I like that. A revenant. I haven't seen one of those in a while. Good pull. Use some flash fire on our chain lightning gear. Well, that's nice. Yeah, it's been way too long since we saw a. Oh. There's more corpses shooting me. About to say a revenant or an arcane horror for that matter. What did he drop? Anything good? Corpse heart, I guess, or is this the revenant? It is! Oh, there you go. A decent shield, pretty good defensive stats, and on hit, gain 3 guard. That's actually a really nice shield. It's a shame that it only has 22 armor rating, though. That's not that great. Is that the prize, though, or is this the prize? Let's gather our loot before we take it. Gather my torch, just in case. Here we go. It's like a scroll. Interesting. The death of Alandrin. Alandrin, our brother. Halindin guide you, Maker guide you. Interesting. Let here the truth be kept, lest you be remembered a traitor, where our sorrows seem a passing woe. Though you swore to serve our people, there were those questioning your heart. Too often have we fought with humans along our borders until the beginning was lost to memory. Rumors of an abduction stirred. As always, their chantry was swift to spread lies. In haste and anger, they killed Siona's sister for wandering too near the hunter's path. You carried her body back to us. You mourned with us. Yet your heart was distracted. Siona begged for vengeance, and you turned away. More and more you vanished without word or explanation. When whispers rose that you would swear yourself to their maker, we feared what would come. Siona sought to save you, to bring you back to us. She had lost a sister, must she also lose a brother? Beneath the trees she saw you with a woman, the one who turned you from us. The woman gestured toward the village. You and she turned to gaze upon the chantry's walls. Siona returned. She told us how humans were turning you against us. How their lies must have filled you. As a loyal servant to the Maker's cause, you would betray our secrets. When we went to ask if there was truth in this, you were already gone. so we sought to stop you. With haste, Siona led her people to the village. There we would challenge you. There we would bring you back to us, or to justice. In the dim of a moonless night, she saw Siona through the trees. She raced towards Siona, crown her lips, and something in her hand. Siona's arrow flew. So the woman fell, the name Elgar'nan dying on her lips, Daisy slipping from her grasp. The men of the village suspected the girl's flight, and heard the scream. They fell upon the elves, but were no match. Siona's haste surpassed your own. You knelt beneath the trees, blood-soaked petals clinging to your clothes from a final embrace. When more humans came, you would not be moved, and they would not listen. Their arrows found your heart, and you fell beside her. We found your body in the river where they cast you aside. She was taken by her own. It was not the end, but your part is past. Rest now as our honored brother once more. A wreath of daisies at your brow, the letter she carried in your hand. Whoever guides you, whoever guides her, may your souls meet once more in the beyond. Faded blood stains the leather. Adeline, what care have I for gods I have never seen, for a maker I do not know? Let others distract themselves with such lofty concerns. I know only this life, I have seen only this world, and I care only for you. Perhaps your priestess distrusts the sincerity of uncivilized elves. If she must hear me, say I will follow the maker, so be it. Your god intercedes as much as ours, my life will not change. I will return in 2 weeks' time. My heart longs for you till then, and will remain with you forever after. Elgar'nan. So that's the story of Elgar'nan, and that might be how the Purge of the Dale started then. With a simple misunderstanding, and as Bioware likes to do, a love story with a very sad ending to it.
It's an account of Red Crossing. When the elves attacked that town, it prompted the exalted march of the Dales.
Aha! Uh-huh.
Taven would want the Dalish to have this.
The Chantry would no doubt be interested in the account as well.
Interesting. So we actually found why the Exalted March started. I guess nobody knew it, because I was saying before that I was wondering what the lore behind that was and what triggered the event. I guess now we know, and nobody did before now. Cry for the past, it shall claim us all, for here rest our saviors newly slain. Others lie beyond our reach, so we remember. Let the true name burn away and enter Dinan Hanin, the place where glory ends. Andrale, whose song inspired, Saran with bow in hand, Siona, who kept the bridge, Talim, who saved the child, Rind, who led them out, Ilan, who kept watch, Elgar'nan, whom we betrayed. A blank space follows the names, as if more were to be carved. Huh. Very interesting. I like this zone. This is a... Again, Bioware's at their strongest, I think, when they combined a story with a dungeon. And I like that it actually had a twist ending, whereas like the other... The Temple of Dirthamin, it didn't really have a twist ending. It was the exact ending you pretty much expected it to have, so it wasn't as interesting there. But I didn't mind the lack of a cool boss fight here, because instead you had that cool little story. Alright, so I guess we should head back out to the Emerald Graves. And we have two choices. We could sell the histories to the Chantry, or return the histories to the Dalish. I kind of don't like the fact that it says sell the histories, like they pay for it, because that makes the choice... It makes it pretty obvious which one is the moral choice here. I'd much rather it was more cloudy and your character could decide whatever makes more sense RP-wise to them. Do they sell it, or do they give it to the Chantry, or give it to the Dalish? Because mine would obviously give it to the Dalish, but I feel like a lot of Heralds of Andraste would probably give it to the Chantry. Maybe use it as a sign that the Inquisition is indeed favored by the Maker. But that's something we're going to have to do in the next episode, so I probably have time for one more tonight. Probably shouldn't, but I will. So I will see you guys in a few minutes, and we will return this story to the Dalish and see what they have to say.